Sometimes I don't even want to let my kids in the house without hosing them down first. And other times I'm the one who needs to be hosed down. So I found a great solution that we can use either at our house or when we're camping. You are not coming in here like that, young lady.
That shower is probably one of the most genius inventions you ever made.
Yes.
Yeah, I'm serious.
Thank you.
It's like, I can put my foot down here.
Yeah.
I can put my arm in here.
Turn the shower on you?
Yeah.
I wouldn't want to get water in your bourbon, though.
For this project, you'll need an 8 or 10 foot length of 3/4 inch PVC pipe, an inexpensive shower head, a 3/4 inch ball valve, a 1/2 inch sillcock, and various PVC connector pieces. You'll also need some PVC cement. Now, don't let this list freak you out. The majority of these items, with the exception of the shower head, are likely to be found in the same aisle in your home improvement store. And while you're there, it's a good idea to fit some of these pieces together and make sure you're getting all the right things, because those bins can get really jumbled up.
I was doing a video a while back where I cut some PVC and I was using different methods to do it, and I guess my dad must have seen it and decided I really needed one of these PVC pipe cutting tools. Problem is, it doesn't have any instructions on how to use it. Ah, okay. Is anybody else reminded of Lorena Bobbitt right now?
The height of this shower, as well as the placement of the water outlets, is entirely up to you and what works for you. The only requirement is that the ball valve, which controls the shower, must go above the sillcock. This way you can run each one individually or both at the same time. The PVC cement dries rather quickly, so make sure you fit everything together first and then go back and glue afterwards.
There's ants all in here. Oy.
That shower is probably one of the most genius inventions you ever made.
I didn't exactly come up with this idea myself. I saw a similar shower a year ago at that same campground, and I thought it was a brilliant idea. That person made their base out of PVC, and I chose to use an umbrella stand simply because I wanted to be able to break it down and make it a little more portable for use in the camper. With PVC, you have to glue everything together, otherwise this happens. This way it's easily portable, and I can attach it to a post or a tree or anything else that I can strap it to.
Well, don't we have like a rubber? What big
rubber? Hi. What's up, my Bruce?